Give you a welcome after what our pastor just did. That was a welcome. The blessing, see, wait. It's the most wonderful time of the year. We are celebrating this evening St. Matthew Tabernacle of Praise Christian Church Party. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We are all here to fellowship. We're going to celebrate the 351st day of the year, celebrating our pastor's birthday. Amen. Turning 60, to God be the glory.
Amen.
I welcome you. We thank you for the presence, tidings of comfort and joy in the season of love. God bless all of you.
Amen. Go ahead.
Praise God. We give honor and glory unto our Heavenly Father. Amen. Now it is time to receive.
Bishop Blackie.
We're going to have the blessing of the meal at this time. Amen.
You're not a substitute, Bishop.
Same thing.
Amen. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this occasion for which we have gathered. Through your grace that has provided this time of celebration. We say thank you, Father, for our dear brother, Dr. Carlton Green, and the family, Father. We pray for the celebration of the birth of your son.
Yes.
And pray, Father, that you would continue to give us the capacity to receive him into our hearts and into our lives. We pray for this food, that it may be nourishment for our bodies. And let us always remember those who are less fortunate. And may we be the hands, Father, that help them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Praise God. We're going to be calling the tables by numbers, so please pay attention to the number on your table.
Thank you for being my pastor. Thank you for loving on me. Thank you for encouraging me. Thank you for letting me know that no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Thank you for pouring in my spirit that greater is he that is in me than he is in the world. And one of my favorite sermons is it in you when the world gets rough and your roads get tough? What's in you? Is it the word? Is it the world? My pastor poured the word into me.
But I want to thank you. I've been with you since I was in the world. And it was your Bible study. You know, it's my testimony to a lot of people. It was your Bible study that had me to cross over. You know, I was coming to St. Matthew's with my mother-in-law. And I thank God that she brought me here because you have planted a lot in me. When I wanted to give up, I didn't because you were standing there with me. Your Bible study gave me the desire to want to come out of
here. I first met C. Berry back in the 90s under the tutelage and pastorship of Reverend McGrew, who, as you guys know, is C. Berry's godfather. Reverend Dr. McGrew. You know, we're real, right? Sometimes we don't get titles right, but we know the person. And what I do know is that Pastor C. Berry Green is real and true. Amen.
I received the answer. I have been there. You have been there for me. You were there when I was a single parent raising 7 children. Who you have blessed our lives. The word. It's the word.
It's the word.
So we as your daughters, we honor you. We praise God for you. We thank you for growing us up in the ministry. We thank you for the word for your talk, spiritually, the spiritual food that we have received. And because of you and what you have taught us, we are mighty great women of God. And we thank you. It's all due to you and the word of God and the God that lives within you. And we thank you and we praise you.
You have been a blessing in my life, and you taught me so much. Even though I don't be here every Sunday, you did teach me a lot. You did teach me to know that God, sheep know His voice, and I started to hear Him as I've been a member there, and I'm growing still.
No, happy birthday to my father. Many of you can imagine, you know, what it's like having to raise me, you know, so the patience. But him always being there. You guys, you know, I hear everyone else talk about how he's been there for lots of you, but you guys wouldn't imagine what he's done for me. Always there to speak, to call, even if we don't live in the same city. Every day we speak, we talk, we joke, we laugh. And I'm just fortunate to have someone like him, you know.
I love you. I got 10 years on you. And don't ever think that you can just push me around. But anyway, Pastor Green gave you this title, for those that don't know. What is my title, somebody?
Miss St. Matthews.
I am Miss St. Matthews. Now, how I got that title, I don't know. I know he's just being funny. But, Pastor, you have seen me raise my children. I think, yeah, you have. All 3 of them. Now I got the great-grandson and the granddaughters. You have kept me grounded. You married me. I made 25 years this time. I got the right one this time.
Sunshine, rain, joy, and pain. Amen. The Lord has kept me. Amen. And so I thank God for each and every one of you. Amen. In case I don't call a name, that's why I'm I'm saying? I thank God for each and every one of you, amen. Thank God, amen. Y'all spoke about my parents. Favor today to go spend some time with my mom. And upon sharing with her that there would be a gathering get together, mother said she wished she could be here. And when she said that, it made both of us cry because I wish my mom could be here, amen. But thank God for her, amen, and her love continuously. She said to tell everybody she loves them and Merry Christmas, amen. Then my lovely wife, amen, let's give it, amen, a hand for her. Just as lovely as can be. Others have shared their story and testimony, and many of y'all know part of hers, but sitting there as dazzling and glowy as she is, she does not look like what she has been through, amen. Praise God, we attribute that to God, amen. Blessed be to be her husband. Amen. I remember when Dr. Price, amen, Apostle Fred Price, my mentor, Mother Betty, had, amen, been challenged with cancer. And I remember him coming to class, amen, one day. And he said that what got her healed and well, he said because he told her it's not right for Fred to dwell alone, amen. And so that made Mother Betty get up out the bed, amen. And so knowing that he had said that, I looked at Lady Regina and said, you know it ain't right for C. Barry to be alone, amen. And so that got her out the bed. So let's thank God, amen. She got back up, amen. Amen. Can't thank her enough. 30 plus years, amen. She has loved me, taken care of me, watched over me. She can tell you things that she did want to do and she did for me. And so thank God for her, amen.
Could not have a David Wood.